Good afternoon. I am Dr. Surekha. I am the Department of Statistics faculty. Now I would like to explain the concept of measures of dispersion. Measures of dispersion means it is the scatteredness. It study the homogeneity and heterogeneity of the distribution. In this, there are four types. They are range, quartile deviation, mean deviation, and standard deviation. Range means the range is the difference between two extreme observations of the distribution. That is, for the given problem, if we calculate the range, then we choose maximum value and minimum value in the distribution. Now, the range is maximum value minus minimum value. And quartile deviation. Quartile deviation is used to measure the quartiles of the data. Means, in this quartile deviation, the data is divided into four parts, four equal parts, Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. And the quartile deviation is given by Qd is equal to Q3 minus Q1 by 2, where Q1 denotes first quartile and Q3 denotes third quartile. It is also known as semi-interquartile range. If we want to calculate the quartile deviation for an ungrouped data, then the first quartile is obtained by size of n plus 1 by 4th item, and the third quartile is obtained by using size of 3 into n plus 1 by 4th item, and the quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 by 2. If we want to calculate quartile deviation for grouped data, then the quartile deviation formula is Q3 minus Q1 by 2, where Q1 is equal to L1 plus N by 4 minus CF1 by F1 into H. Here, L1 denotes lower limit of the first quartile class, CF1 denotes cumulative frequency of the class preceding to the first quartile class, F1 denotes frequency of the first quartile class, and H denotes the width of the quartile class or class interval. And Q3 is equal to L3 plus 3N by 4 minus CF3 by F3 into H, where L3 denotes lower limit of the third quartile class, C3 denotes cumulative frequency of the class preceding to the third quartile class, and F3 denotes frequency of the third quartile class. And the third method is mean deviation. The mean deviation is the arithmetic mean of absolute deviations from mean or median or mode. It is usually denoted by MD. If we want to calculate mean deviation for an ungrouped data, then the mean deviation is summation xi minus a by, mean deviation is summation mod xi minus a by n, where n denotes size of the sample observations and a is either mean or median or mode. And mean deviation for grouped data. For the discrete or continuous series, the mean deviation is summation fi into mod xi minus a by n, where capital N denotes total frequency and a denotes either mean or median or mode. And the last method is standard deviation. Standard deviation is the positive square root of the arithmetic mean of the squares of deviations of the given values from the arithmetic mean, and is denoted by sigma or standard deviation. If we want to calculate the standard deviation for an ungrouped data, sigma is equal to square root of 1 by n summation xi minus x bar whole square, where x bar denotes the mean and n denotes the number of sample observations. If we want to calculate standard deviation for discrete or continuous series, then sigma is equal to square root of 1 by n summation fi xi minus x bar whole square, where n denotes total frequency. And variance. Variance is the arithmetic mean of squares of deviations from their arithmetic mean and is denoted by sigma square. The square of the standard deviation is called variance and is denoted by sigma square. If you want to calculate the variance for individual series, then sigma square is equal to 1 by n summation xi minus x bar whole square, where x bar denotes the mean of the given data and n denotes the number of sample observations. If you want to calculate variance for grouped data, it means either discrete series or continuous series, then the variance can be calculated by sigma square is equal to 1 by n summation fi into xi minus x bar whole square, where x bar denotes the mean of the discrete series or continuous series and n denotes total frequency. Now, another concept, moments, skewness and kurtosis. Moments are nothing but the statistical averages. In these moments, there are two types, non-central moments and central moments. First, I would like to explain the concept of non-central moments. Non-central means the earth moment about any point A are called non-central moments, and it is denoted by mu r dash. Mu r dash is 1 by n summation fi xi minus a whole power r, means earth non-central moment. Here capital N nothing but total frequency, and di means difference, is nothing but the deviation between the observed value and the point, means di is equal to xi minus a. Now mu r dash is equal to 1 by n summation fi di power r. If we take the point A is equal to 0, then the non-central moments are called raw moments, and these moments are also denoted by the letter mu r dash, and mu r dash is given by 1 by n summation fi xi power r. If r is equal to 1, then we get mu 1 dash and is nothing but mean. If r is equal to 2, then mu 2 dash is 1 by n summation fi xi square. Similarly, r is equal to 3 and r is equal to 4. And central moments. The earth moments about the mean are called central moments, means the deviations taken about the central value. And these central moments are denoted by mu r and is given by mu r is equal to 1 by n summation fi xi minus x bar whole power r. Here capital N denotes total frequency, and the deviation xi minus x bar is denoted by zi. Then the mu r is given by 1 by n summation fi zi power r. If we take r is equal to 0 in mu r, then we get mu naught is equal to 1. If we take r is equal to 1 in mu 1, then we get mu 1 is equal to 0. If we take r is equal to 2 in mu r, then we get mu 2. Mu 2 is nothing but 1 by n summation fi xi minus x bar whole square. This formula is nothing but the variance. Therefore, mu 2 is equal to sigma square, means the variance of the variable x. And some of the uses of the moments. These moments are useful to find the statistical averages. Means first moment about origin is nothing but mean, and it is denoted by mu 1 dash. And the second moment about mean is nothing but variance and is denoted by mu 2. The measure of skewness is calculated by using third central moment, that is mu 3. And the measure of kurtosis is calculated by using fourth central moment, is mu 4. Now, I would like to explain the concept of skewness. Skewness means lack of symmetry. Lack of symmetry means it gives an idea about the shape of the curve of the given data. A distribution is said to be skewed if mean, median and mode fall at different points, that is mean not equal to median not equal to mode, and the quartiles are not equidistant from the median, that is Q3 minus Q2 not equal to Q2 minus Q1. And the curve drawn with the help of the given data is not symmetrical but stretched more to one side than to the other. Just I would like to explain the concept of skewness by using these diagrams. In A, it is negatively skewed. Negatively skewed means the curve towards the left hand side. In this, mean is greater than, median is greater than mode. And if we observe in point C, means positively skewed distribution, we observed that the curve is towards right side. In this situation, mode is greater than, median is greater than mean. If the curve is stretched normal, means mean, median and mode are fall at same points and the quartiles are equidistant from the median. If we want to calculate the skewness, then we use these measures. These measures are, in this there are several types of measures of skewness. And first one is absolute measure of skewness. If we want to find the skewness, means lack of symmetry, then one of the formulas are skewness is equal to mean minus median, or skewness is equal to mean minus mode, or skewness is equal to Q3 minus median minus of median minus Q1. Median nothing but second quartile. And the another method for finding the measures of skewness is Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewness. The Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewness is mean minus mode by standard deviation. In this case, if mode is ill-defined, then by using the empirical mode, means mode is equal to 3 median minus 2 mean. Now we substitute the mode formula, that is 3 median minus 2 mean, in the above relation, we get skewness is equal to 3 into mean minus median by standard deviation. And the limits for this coefficient of skewness is plus or minus 3. And another way of finding the skewness are Bowley's coefficient of skewness. And for this, the skewness formula is Sk is equal to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2 median by Q3 minus Q1. If we have only moments, by using these moments, the coefficient of skewness is Sk is equal to square root of beta 1 into beta 2 plus 3 by 2 into 5 beta 2 minus 6 beta 1 minus 9. Here B1 denotes mu3 square by mu2 cube and B2 denotes mu4 by mu2 square. Skewness, in this case, either skewness may be positive or negative. And they may be no skewed, called symmetrical distribution. Symmetrical means the type of the curve, B type of the curve is called symmetrical distribution, whereas A and C are skewed curves. And the last concept, kurtosis. The kurtosis means the measure of central tendency, dispersion and skewness may not give the complete idea about the distribution. Therefore, another statistical measure is required to know about the flatness or peakness of the curve, called kurtosis. And it is discovered by Professor Carl Pearson, and this is also known as Pearson's kurtosis, is also known as convexity of the curve. And the measure for the kurtosis is given by beta 2 or gamma 2, where beta 2 is mu 4 by mu 2 square and gamma 2 is beta 2 minus 3. This is the shape of the curve. Means, if the curve towards flatter than normal curve, in the center of the curve is normal curve, and the normal curve is also known as mesokurtic. For this normal curve, beta 2 is 3 and gamma 2 is equal to 0. If the curve flatter than normal curves, means it is known as platycurtic. In this situation, beta 2 less than 3 and gamma 2 less than 0. If the curve more than normal curve, means more peaked than normal, then it is known as leptocurtic. For such curve, beta 2 greater than 3 and gamma 2 greater than 0. Now I would like to explain these methods by using some problems. If we want to calculate the range of the values 7, 9, 15, 14, 6, 8. For we calculate the range, first we have to identify the maximum number and minimum number. In the given data, the maximum number is 15 and the minimum number is 6. Now the range is 15 minus 6 is 9. If we want to calculate the mean deviation to the given data, in the given data, they give only class intervals and frequencies. By using these class intervals, we have to calculate the mid values by using the formula lower limit plus upper limit by 2. and next column FIXI. FIXI means the frequencies are multiplied with mid values. By using FIXI, we calculate, first we have to calculate mean. X bar is equal to, the given data is continuous series and X bar is given by summation FIXI by N. In this, total FIXI is 2540 and capital N is 60. By calculating this, we get X bar is equal to 42.33. By using these values, first we have to calculate mod X minus X bar, means each and every value of the mid value subtracted from mean, means mod 5 minus 42.33, and the last column is obtained by the resultant value multiplied with frequency, means 3 into mod 5 minus 37.33. By using these method, we get summation FI into mod XI minus X bar. Now the mean deviation is 921.36 by total frequency, that is 60, we get 15.36. If we want to calculate the quartile deviation for the continuous series, in the continuous series the class intervals are from 10 to 15 to 60 to 70, and here the frequencies are given. First we have to calculate the cumulative frequencies. Cumulative frequencies are obtained by first frequency, take it as value, and the second frequency is adding first two frequencies, and the third frequencies is third cumulative frequency is obtained by adding the frequencies of 1, 2, 3, and the fourth cumulative frequency is obtained by adding the frequencies of 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that we calculate the cumulative frequency. Here Q1 is, first we have to calculate N by 4. N by 4 means, capital N means total frequency, 80 by 4 means 20. First we have to check the 20 in the cumulative frequency. If there is 20 in CF, take the corresponding class interval as Q1 class. Otherwise, just greater to the 20 value, means 31. The corresponding class interval is 20 to 25 is the first quartile class, and F1 is 15 and CF1 is 16, and H is the height of the interval, means 5. By using these values we calculate Q1. For Q3, first we have to calculate 3N by 4. 3N by 4 value is 60. First we observe the 60 in the cumulative frequency. If it is, the corresponding class is the third quartile class. If it is not, then we use greater to the 60 value, means 65. The corresponding class is 30 to 40. So now 30 to 40 is the third quartile class, and the frequency corresponding to the class means 12 is the F3 and 53 is the CF. By using this formula, we calculate Q3, and the quartile deviation is Q3 minus Q1 by 2, means 39.05 minus 21.56 by 2. We get 8.745 is the quartile deviation for the given data. If we want to calculate standard deviation for the continuous series, means here there are class intervals from 0 to 10, 10 to 20, up to 40 to 50, and the frequencies are also given. First we have to calculate, convert these class intervals into mid values by using mid value formula, lower limit plus upper limit by 2, means 0 plus 10 by 2. After getting mid values, now we have to calculate fx, means multiply the frequencies, each and every value of the frequency multiplied with mid values, means 12 into 5, 33 into 15, 30 into 25, up to 10 into 45. After finding fx, we have to calculate the total of that column and fx square. Now the standard deviation formula is sigma is equal to square root of summation fx square by n minus summation fx by n whole square. By substituting these values in the sigma, we get 11.45. Next, if we want to calculate moments or skewness or kurtosis for the continuous series. Means the data is given class interval and frequency. First we have to solve the given problem in a tabular form by taking class interval as the first class and frequency is the second column. First we have to convert the class intervals into mid values denoted by xi by using the formula lower limit plus upper limit by 2. After finding the mid values, we have to find the next column, means deviations. Deviations means observed value, given mid value minus any assumed value. Here I will take 35 as the assumed value, and h means height of the class intervals, that is xi minus 35 by 10. Means for the first value 5 minus 35 by 10 we get minus 3, and second 15 minus 35 by 10 we get minus 2. Similarly we have to find up to last value. After finding the di values, we have to calculate fidi, fidi square, fidi cube and fidi power 4 for 4 moments. After finding these values, first we have to calculate the non-central moments. In this I will take a arbitrary point A as 35. Now mu 1 dash is h into 1 by n summation fi di, that is 10 into 25 by 100 we get 2.5. similarly mu 2 dash, mu 3 dash and mu 4 dash, and these are the central moments. The central moments are mu 2 is mu 2 dash minus mu 1 dash whole square. Here mu 2 dash and mu 1 dash are nothing but non-central moments. By using non-central moments, we have to calculate central moments, means mu 2, mu 3, mu 4. By using these central moments, we have to calculate the skewness, means beta 1 is equal to mu 3 square by mu 2 cube, we get 0.0247. Here 0.0247 is greater than 0, means the above distribution is positively skewed distribution. And we have to know the type of the curve. We have to calculate beta 2, and beta 2 is given by mu 4 by mu 2 square, that is 2.93. this value is less than 3, that means the given distribution is platy-kurtic distribution.